Please join me in prayer. Gracious God, thank you for this great moment in our school year as we honor those who honor you by excellence in their studies and their service. Guide these activities now as we celebrate together in your name. Amen. Thank you.
that awesome? Thank you all so much. Good afternoon and welcome to this year's convocation. This is a time to celebrate the best and brightest of our student body and to give thanks for this gifted faculty for your commitment and dedication to your students. We march in academic regalia today as a tribute to all of those who have dedicated themselves to their students and their scholarship throughout the ages. Now let's begin with today's celebration.
Good afternoon. Based on superior performance in the classroom, as evidenced by an exceptional grade point average, it is my privilege today to present the Outstanding Academic Achievement Award in Accounting to Summer Marcy. It is my honor and privilege today to announce the School of Business Management Award for Outstanding Academic Achievement to Samuel Lowe. It is my privilege this afternoon to give the award for the Outstanding Academic Achievement in Recreation, Tourism, and Sport Management to Lexi Paksala.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is my pleasure this afternoon to present the Human Resources Outstanding Achievement Award to two very deserving students, among many deserving students this afternoon. We want you to know that. These two students I've had the privilege of teaching throughout their career here in the area of human resources, and so this afternoon I would like to recognize Courtney Sandlin and Tyler Williams. I do believe Tyler was ill today, so we will make sure that he gets his award. Thank you.
Mr. President, other dignitaries, distinguished faculty, class of 2017, relatives, friends, family, and guests. The Education Division is most pleased to provide a number of awards today for future outstanding educators. As I call your name, will you please come forward as a group? For P5 Elementary Education, Amy Farman. Outstanding. Middle grades English, Sydney, Florida leads. Please stay up here. Middle grades mathematics, Elizabeth Smith. Please stay up here. Middle grades science, Caleb Keaton. Elizabeth, please stay up for a picture. Congratulations. 812 secondary education, Rebecca Nguyen. Elizabeth, congratulations. Please stay up. And last but not least, P12 physical education and health, Joe Kozar. Please stay up.
I will be presenting awards for Christian Ministries, English, and Theater for Outstanding Senior. First for Christian Ministries, will Tyler Harding please come forward. For outstanding academic achievement in English, good Rebecca Sanders, please come forward. We have two from the theater program. The Alpha Eta Gamma Outstanding Thespian Award that goes to, actually there are two winners of this. The first one is to David Harding. I think he knows Tyler, maybe. And the other to Susan Harrington.
Hello. My pleasure today to distribute the awards for the Division of Natural Sciences and Mathematics. Today I'm going to be distributing five different awards to four deserving individuals, so you get to figure that out. But the first one I'd like to distribute is our outstanding biology graduating senior outstanding student award that goes to Colby Allen. Thank you. Colby has worked hard, very hard, successfully holding a 4.0 as a biology major and chemistry minor. But he's also extremely active as a tutor and lab assistant, helping lots of the professors and also students both in and... You have a seat. Sorry. Didn't mean to screw up things. So, but assisting the professors and also students both in his graduating class and many of the younger ones via the tutoring efforts. So, thank you. Okay, next award I would like to present is the Mathematics Award. So how about I run through the details. This young lady, among other things, she completed the mathematics criteria and went after a bunch of challenging electives and then subsequently lobbied to have more electives because it wasn't challenging enough. But she, the electives that she did run through, frankly, I don't understand them, but I'll just read the names. Abstract Algebra 1, Group Theory, and Combinatorics apparently were some of the things that she mastered. Again, I'm reading it. I don't have a clue what the heck they mean. I thought algebra was abstract enough without having to go to another one. But anyway, long story short, this young lady is apparently has already prepared for and passed a couple actuary exams and heading off to Illinois State University to pursue a master's in mathematics with an emphasis on actuarial science. So I'd like to congratulate Amanda Gerald. And before you run away, stay here. This is where the five awards for four students comes in. Amanda also has been chosen and recognized for the Mathematics Peer Tutor Award from her colleagues, actually from her colleagues and also the various students. Long story short, she's helped both individuals in the high-level classes and individuals in the low-level classes. And the primary claim to fame relative to my understanding is the last one, dramatically sought after by her students that she was helping. So you helped them out and they kept saying, we want more Amanda. So with that, congratulations on the certificate. Okay, the next award that I have the privilege of distributing is the 2016 Fauser Environmental Award. This goes to a young lady who was also a biology major, chemistry minor. This young lady performed extremely well in the classroom, but also exhibited a huge passion, particularly in the biology area, and more importantly, a focus of marine science. And individual is hoping to go towards the University of Florida Veterinary School in the near future with a marine animal emphasis. So. Elizabeth Caldwell? Okay. I don't see her anywhere. That award, like I said, that was the Environmental Award, Fauser Award, that not only has a lovely certificate, it comes with one of these lovely things that, lovely blue and white paper that you sign that turns into some green paper. So maybe, hey, stick that one in. Okay. The last award that I get to distribute here is to another young lady, a very deserving young lady. This is the Mohs Dunning Science Education Award. This young lady is a middle grades education major specializing in science and English. Kudos from all of her professors in all three subjects, English, education, and science. She currently holds a 3.8 and is heading off for student teaching in the fall. And like to congratulate here Delina Ballou. Again, I don't see either one, so we will get these certificates and the appropriate cash remunerations to them in the near future. So thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Marion Smith, and I'm the chair of the newly formed Division of Nursing and Health, and I'm joined by my colleague this afternoon, Dr. Bill Neese. We have the privilege of distributing awards for psychophysiology, psychology, and nursing. The first award is the Outstanding Senior Psychophysiology Major Award. This year, the recipient has a perfect 4.0 GPA with a major in psychophysiology, minors in chemistry and Christian ministry. While at Lindsay Wilson, she has been a women's soccer player, been on two mission trips to the Dominican Republic and Belize, and volunteered at the remote area medical clinics. Please join me in congratulating outstanding psychophysiology major, Gloria Hensley. Next, we would like to award the Outstanding Senior Psychology Major Award. This goes to a student who has a double major in psychology and English and has also maintained a very impressive GPA of 3.94. This student played JV basketball during her time at Lindsey Wilson College. Please join us in congratulating Jordan Perry on a job well done. Next, we move to the Nursing Awards. At this time, I would like to present the Cohort Nursing Awards. Nursing students enter the BSN pre-licensure program at the sophomore level and progress through the curriculum in a cohort format. Each year, there are students within each cohort who soar to a level of recognition that differentiates them from their peers. The nursing faculty wish to recognize these students for their engagement in the major, their academic rigor, their standards of excellence in clinical practice, and their continued commitment to success as future nurses. This year, Cohort 6 recipient, which sounds so wild considering we're such a baby program, but our Cohort 6 recipient is Leslie Pelston. The Cohort 5 recipient is Rosalyn Wilson. The Senior Cohort 4 recipient is a student that the faculty have unanimously selected to receive the award of Outstanding Cohort 4. This student has excelled academically, and for those of you who may not know anything about national standardized exams as preparation for the licensure exam for nursing, I want to share with you that this student is achieving nearly perfect scores on all benchmark exams, which is pretty much unheard of. She also has been notified that she is a finalist at Duke University as one of the recipients in their nursing graduate program for surgical nurses. Please join me in congratulating Sarah Schell. Not sure if this person is here this afternoon, Amy Wethington. Amy is a student in our online RN to BSN program, and she was selected by the faculty who teach in that program to receive the RN to BSN Outstanding Student Award. It's my understanding Amy also just had a baby, which explains why she probably isn't here, but we congratulate Amy Wethington. And the last award in this particular category goes to the senior nursing student who has achieved academic excellence for the 4 years they have been a student at Lindsey Wilson College. The nursing curriculum is a rigorous curriculum composed of 57 credit hours and over 800 clocked clinical hours within a 3-year period. Program and degree completion is rigorous, demanding, and rewarding. This particular Lindsey Wilson BSN graduate is steeped in liberal arts education. She is an exemplary student in the classroom. She always pays attention. I always look for her eyes when I'm describing or explaining difficult concepts. But beyond that, this student excels in compassion and love for her peers and all those that she provides care to. Please join me in congratulating senior Casey Smallwood on achieving the Academic Excellence Award.
I was trying to think about what to say about the students we're going to honor from the Social Sciences and Interdisciplinary Studies program. I was reminded of a quote that made a difference in my life, and anybody who comes to my office sees this prominently displayed. It says that whatever you can do or dream you can, begin it. Boldness has genius, power, and magic in it. It was said to have been a quote from Goethe, but there's some discussion about whether he really said it or not. We won't go there. But the point of that quote for me was it was a simple, bold step of actually taking a GRE test to get into graduate school. For each of you, it was taking that bold step to take the test and to complete the courses that you needed to be here today and to be honored for your achievements, and I congratulate you for that. So it makes me very proud to be able to honor the students at our communication and criminal justice and social sciences and history and journalism, media studies have put together as being the students who most deserve the recognition today, starting with the communication program. And I don't know all the students, but I do know this student because she was a member of my public speaking class so long ago, and that's a privilege to have all of you in our public speaking classes to see you excel here today. But Christina Falls, our recipient of this award, was someone who decided after declaring a major in business that she would go on into communication instead, but keeping the minor in business and the minor in Christian studies. So please join with me in recognizing Ms. Christina Falls from Orangeburg. Criminal justice is very special to my heart. And the student today is from Eaglesville, Pennsylvania. She's not only a great student, she's also excelled in tennis. And she's a member of the Alpha Phi Sigma National Criminal Justice Honor Society. And recently learned that she's been accepted at Temple University for law school. So we commend her for that. After completing 260 hours of an internship in the Philadelphia Office of the District Attorney. So please join with me in congratulating Jessica Marie King. Giving you your awards. Give Christina hers. There
you go. Christina, I'm going to keep them.
Okay. And so, our next student, I'm told by the faculty that he is someone who is honored because of his optimism, his thoughtfulness, and his commitment to the study of history and social science education. So, Josh Powers, would you please join me up on the stage? Turn it over to my colleague here.
The Media Studies program honors three students for outstanding achievement. For outstanding achievement in journalism, Liliana Pearson. For outstanding achievement in student publications, Mariah Stern. For outstanding achievement in performance for media studies, Zach Oakes. Zach will be interning at the Somerset Daily, this newspaper this summer. Liliana will hopefully be at WOKH-FM and WLSK-FM in Bardstown. And Mariah Stearns will be at WTVQ-ABC in Lexington.
Today I am presenting the award for the Outstanding Human Services and Counseling graduate. The gentleman that wins this honor has a 3.93 in the program as far as GPA, a quiet gentleman with a servant's heart, Daylen Nguyen.
Good afternoon. My name is Jeff Crane with Sarah Durham. Join me on the stage. On behalf of the School of Professional Counseling, it is my privilege and honor to recognize Sarah Durham for her outstanding academic achievement. And it is a pleasure to. We have two Sarah Durhams, so it is a pleasure to offer.
Good afternoon. I'm Regina Hogan. I'm the director of the AIM Evening College Program, and I'd like to invite Nicole Jones to join me on stage, please. Nicole has performed remarkably well academically since her return to the classroom as a criminal justice major, and she's represented both the AIM program and the college impeccably well. I'm so proud to present Nicole as this year's recipient of the Evening College Outstanding Achievement Award.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is my honor to represent Lindsey Wilson College Choral Ensembles. Many of you know of my love for sports and sports analogies, and that we refer to Slider 202 as the locker room of the choral program. The locker room is where we draw up maneuvers and plays and rehearse them. The locker room is where championship banners hang, representing performances in currently 33 states, 7 countries, 3 Carnegie Hall performances, as well as the key to the city of Milford, Connecticut. We have an incredible cohort of seniors graduating from the Lindsey Wilson College Singers this year, and we are proud of their service and their work. Today I'm pleased to share with you about a stellar accomplishment. The project began in July 2014, and the construction, if you will, was completed in June 2015, thus coming after this particular gathering last academic year. Would the students who performed in Austria join me on the stage, please? 11 choral students worked well beyond the repertoire of their ensembles in order to perfect the literature requirements for performing in the Mozart Choral Festival in Salzburg, Austria. We are incredibly proud of these students for rising to this caliber and level of performance and for their representation of Lindsey Wilson College. Several of these students have graduated, and we have taken the liberty to have them on the phone for this presentation. I'd like to introduce to you Emily Baker, John Brown, Troy Butler, Stephen Chafin, Amber Clark, Kate Durham, Quentin Ford, Maria Hook, Jared Hunter, Bailey Scott, and Eli Young. Would you join me in congratulating them?
Thanks. I'm very pleased to recognize the Honor Corps recipients among our graduating seniors this afternoon. Of course, receiving an Honor Corps represents hours of long work over the college career of the students who are going to be recognized. When I call the color of your corps, would you please stand to be recognized? Blue. The blue corps represents Associate Honors graduates. Those graduates who have completed their degree with a 3.50 or higher. So congratulations. If you're wearing a white Honor Corps, please stand. Graduates wearing the white Honor Corps are graduating with distinction or cum laude, a GPA of 3.50 to 3.69. Congratulations. Please stand if you're wearing a purple cord. Graduates wearing the purple cord are graduating with high distinction or magna cum laude, a GPA of 3.70 to 3.89. If you're wearing a gold honor cord, please stand. Graduates wearing the gold honor cord are those graduating with highest distinction or summa cum laude, a GPA of 3.9 to 4.0. Congratulations to you all.
This next award starts with a history lesson. It's the Noma Dix Winston History Scholarship Award, and this award is given each year to an outstanding sophomore student who is committed to completing a history bachelor's of arts major at Lindsay Wilson College. The award was created in 1989 to honor former Lindsay faculty member Noma, not Norma, Dix Winston, who taught history from the early 1940s to the early 1980s. A stellar student who's described as enthusiastic, thoughtful, and hardworking, and was a true commitment to excellence and a passion for history, is this year's Noma Dix Winston Scholarship recipient. In her spare time, she also works in the library, and her colleagues there say she's a perfect mix of goofy and intelligent. So please welcome with me this year's scholarship recipient, Ms. Taylor Southward from Monticello, Kentucky.
Each spring, the Center for Entrepreneurship sponsors a business concept competition. The competition was held on April the 14th this year. We had a total of 32 teams with 80 students participating. The winner of this competition is always the selection for the Center for Entrepreneurship Award. This year, we have a team of three young men who won the award, and I want to tell you that they will be traveling to Lexington, Kentucky, Friday and Saturday of this week and competing at the state level at Idea State U. Please join me in congratulating them today and wishing them luck this weekend. I have Michael Hart, Alec Mueller, and Wes Murphy.
Good afternoon. Thank you for being here and part of our celebration of our student accomplishments. I'm here to present the Emily Vickers Endowed Award in Art. This year's recipient is a very talented and promising student in both emphasis areas, digital and studio. It's my pleasure to present this award to Courtney Flicker.
It is my pleasure to present the Alma Jones Wade Scholarship, which carries a $5,000 award. Traditionally, this award is presented to the student who finishes as the runner-up in the Begley Scholars Competition. This year's recipient is a sophomore from Brooksville, Kentucky. She's a brilliant young woman with a 26 ACT and a 3.9 GPA. Would you please join me in recognizing this year's recipient of the Alma Jones Wade Scholarship, Carly Jefferson.
My pleasure this afternoon to announce the winner of the Boyd Lupker Award for Excellence in Oral Communication. Bobby Boyd Lupker and John Lynn Lupker have established an annual award to recognize students who have made outstanding oral presentations during the year. The award is in memory of Mrs. Lupker's mother, who taught speech for many years. The Lupkers particularly value oral communications that reflect scholarship and research. This year's recipient of the Boyd Lupker Award is Rebecca Sanders for an outstanding presentation during the fall honors convocation. And the award does carry a cash stipend, which Rebecca can use when she goes to graduate school, right?
Thank you. Could you get a picture with Dr. Phelps? I'm really his stand-in. Okay.
The next award I'd like to present is the R.V. Bennett Scholarship Award. The Lindsay Wilson Honors Program was initiated in 2008 and is named in honor of Lindsay Wilson's first president, R.V. Bennett. The R.V. Bennett Scholarship Award is presented to the honor student who has demonstrated the best leadership to the program and helped to advance the program's mission, which focuses on challenging our academically strong students, expanding and deepening their worldviews, and encouraging them to be leaders in public service. This year, we are pleased to honor Lane Thompson, who has been an active participant in the Honors Program for the last 3 years. This also carries a cash stipend.
It is my pleasure to present the Elizabeth Lowe Whitfield Nursing Professional Development Award. As I've stated in the last two previous years at this ceremony, we are very fortunate in the world to have luminaries and generous spirits who see the needs of students or graduates even before they can imagine what those needs might be. Lindsay Wilson College alumnus and wonderful friend, Dr. Elizabeth Lowe Whitfield, affectionately known as Ms. Lindsay Wilson, was one of those luminaries and generous spirits for this college. Through the legacy gifts of the late Miss Elizabeth and her husband, Ken, who I see actually every week, we are able to award the Elizabeth Lowe Whitfield Professional Nursing Award. The recipient of the award is a graduating senior selected by the nursing faculty who embodies the qualities and characteristics of the professional nurse. The recipient demonstrates excellent academic performance, competent practice, and a desire to pursue continued professional study. This year, the nursing faculty are very proud to present the Dr. Elizabeth Lowe Whitfield Professional Nursing Award to a very special senior student. I know that the nursing faculty are joined by the faculty and the Division of Education because this student, during a time of unforeseen circumstances, worked in the Division of Education and reached out to those faculty when their administrative assistant passed away at a very unexpected time. Please join the nursing faculty and the education faculty in congratulating our senior, Darian Dalton.
Good afternoon. My name is Amy Thompson Wells, and I am the Director of Civic Engagement and Student Leadership here at Lindsay and co-director of the Bonner Scholar Program. Will the following students please join me on stage? Troy Butler, Laura Fies, Leanne Landis, Kristen Lesher, Sheila Marie Stacy, and Kyle Wiener. Yes. These students aren't just volunteers. We like to consider them or refer to them as change makers in our community. And these Bonner Scholars and Bonner Volunteer have completed just over or close to 12,000 hours of service at 21 community partner sites. The value of their service is equivalent to $85,559. Please give these change makers a round of applause. So, in honor of your outstanding performance and dedication to community service and servant leadership, it is my pleasure to present you with your Certificate of Service Excellence. Troy? All right. Pull up this one here. Thank you.
I'm Denise Fudge, and I would like to invite Mr. Aaron Goo to join me this afternoon. Aaron has been our outstanding student employment student for the last 4 years in the art department. He is from Summershade, an education major, and I'm glad you're here because I was afraid you'd be student teaching this afternoon. But he is the recipient of the Work Study Student of the Year Award.
Good afternoon. I'm Miranda Garner, and I'm the tutor coordinator here at Lindsay Wilson College. If you are a tutor in the Academic Success Center, please stand and be recognized at this time. I just want to thank each of you tutors for your service and your dedication to the students. In terms of their success, what you do, there's not enough money that we could pay you in terms of what you have done for our students the past 4 years. Before I ask the individual to come forward to receive this award, I want just to say a few words about that person. Honestly, I could speak for hours and still not say enough about what this individual has done for our tutoring program and for the students. In terms of the coursework, this individual has tutored in General Chemistry 1, General Chemistry 2, Organismal Biology, Cellular Biology, Genetics, Organic Chemistry 1 and 2, all those science classes, Physics 1 and 2. Let me tell you, when I'm working late, which is often, and 6:30 rolls around and those physics students come in, sometimes I just quit what I'm doing and just listen. Because honestly, I don't really understand a thing about physics, but when I listen to this individual explain the material, I find myself very interested. And perhaps over the last 3 or 4 years, maybe I have learned a little bit as well. Colby Allen, please come forward.
Good afternoon, I'm Jared Odd. I'm the Writing Center Coordinator here at Lindsay Wilson College. I'm here to present the award for Outstanding Achievement in Writing Center Peer Tutoring. This student's enthusiasm and dedication as a writer and a writing consultant are born of genuine interest. Talk to her for a few minutes in the Writing Center and you will know that she sincerely wants to read what you have to say. This genuine interest, more than anything else a reader can offer, helps a writer produce his or her best writing. This award goes to Karen Mason. Carrie graduated in December and had to be at work today, so I'll give this to her when I see her next.
The Enactus Award goes to someone who is very innovative and creative, because innovation is the key and creativity is the key to becoming very successful in business. These three students have competed in outside business competitions, regional competitions, and they have excelled greatly. It is my honor to award the Outstanding Team Member Award to Michael Hart, Wes Murphy, and Zach Lawson.
Thank you. I'm here today to give the award for the Writing Fellow of the Year Award. Writing fellows are people who are both excellent excellent writers, but also excellent in their field. And if you're a writing fellow right now, can you stand up? Are you graduating? Stand up. Thank you. Thank you so much. Well, most students here have either been a writing fellow or benefited from a writing fellow, and so we appreciate that. And the two people that we're giving awards to are Carrie Mason, who's going to U of L in the fall, and then Nolan Dant. Nolan here? I know. And Nolan's actually going into our human service program in counseling in Louisville, so thanks.
I have the honor of presenting two awards for Orpheus. Orpheus is the college literary magazine, which is now available at InSlider, and would like first to thank Dr. Fitz Shanklin and Dr. Allison Smith for their work with that. I don't know if I'm looking the right way or not, but to thank them for their work with that. We have two. We have two recipients. Would Olivia Garth please come? And I hope I said that properly. Okay. Olivia has won the award for poetry. The award winner for fiction is Carrie Mason. I understand from the previous speech that Carrie is not here, but she won the award anyway, and this will get to her. Okay.
Good afternoon. My name is Jake Saylor, and I'm the student body president here, and I am going to be presenting the Club of the Year Award. Before I present this award, I'd like to commend every member, leader, and faculty member who's participated in clubs. It's been an excellent year for clubs, if I do say so myself, and I'm just proud of all the work that you all have done, and I'm really thankful to be a part of it. This club in particular has done an amazing job in student involvement and getting people involved on campus, and they've been doing this longer than I've been here as a student. And their dedication to their mission and the hard work that they put in every week is what pushed the student body to vote for them. And it is my honor to award the Club of the Year for the 2015-16 school year to Life. Can I get like a faculty member or somebody to come up here and get this award? Troy, Ms. Carroll, Calhoun, Mr. Tyler. Somebody has to take this award. I can't keep it. They didn't give me any money.
Good afternoon. My name is Tim Curry, and I'm the faculty athletics representative, and I'm here to recognize our male and female student athletes of the year. Would Jessica King and John Paul Williamson please come forward? As I say each year on this day, there are students who are gifted athletically, and there are those students who are high achievers academically, and then there are those who excel in both these areas, and two such students have been chosen as this year's male and female student athletes of the year. Our women's scholar athlete of the year, or student athlete of the year, is Jessica King. Jessica is a member of the tennis team and is from Worcester Township, Pennsylvania. Her previous honors and awards are as follows. She was named NAIA Scholar Athlete in 2015 and 2016, and only juniors and seniors will accumulative grade point average of 3.5 or higher are considered for this honor. She was named All-Mid-South Conference in 2014 and 2015, and I should mention that the 2016 All-Conference Awards have not been announced, but hopefully she'll make it three straight. She's been named Academic All-Mid-South Conference the past 3 years, 2014, 15, and 16. Her career singles record at Lindsey Wilson is 39 and 14, and her doubles record is 44 and 16. And finally, she was named 2015 NAIA All-American in the sport of women's tennis. Jessica accomplished this while earning a 3.65 grade point average. Please join me in recognizing this year's Female Student Athlete of the Year, Jessica King. John Paul is not with us today, but John Paul Williamson is our Male Student Athlete of the Year. He is a member of the cross country and track teams, and he came to us from Derry, Ireland. His honors and awards are as follows. He was a 2014 and 2015 NAIA Scholar Athlete, and again, that's open only to juniors and seniors with a 3.5 GPA. He was named All-Mid-South Conference in the sport of men's cross country all four seasons, 2012, 13, 14, and 15. He was academic All-Mid-South Conference in the sport of cross country the past 3 years, 2013, 14, and 15. He was also named academic All-Mid-South Conference in the sport of track and field in the past 3 years, 2014, 15, and 16. He was 2015 All-Mid-South Conference in the sport of track and field. He was the 2012 Mid-South Conference Cross Country Freshman Runner of the Year 3 years ago. And then this year, he was the 2015 Mid-South Conference Overall Cross Country Runner of the Year. And finally, he was named 2015 NAIA All-American in the sport of cross country. And in addition, he was also named 2015 NAIA All-American in the sport of indoor track. John Paul accomplished this while earning a 3.45 grade point average. Please join me in recognizing this year's Male Student Athlete of the Year, John Paul Williams.
One of the things I love most about going to Lindsey Wilson College is how you get to interact with your teachers and how you get to know them and how they become a really personal part of your experience. And if you were to ask every student in here today, they would probably say the same thing, that they have that one teacher who's made an impact in their life. And if you were to ask any given of those students asked, they would say that this teacher fits that bill as well. This teacher understands that teachers are an important part of the college experience, and he keeps this in mind every day as he puts his heart and soul into everything that he does. And he cares about his students and lives out the mission every student every day. The 2015-16 Teacher of the Year, as voted by the student body, is Mr. Benson Sexton.
The winner of the United Methodist Exemplary Teacher Award for this year. Each year, a faculty member is honored as a United Methodist Church Exemplary Teacher of the Year. The award is made possible by the Global Board of Higher Education Ministry of the Church. Nomination for the awards are made by the faculty, with the final selection being made by the Faculty Affairs Council. The criteria for the award include excellence in teaching, commitment to value-centered education, civility and concern for students and colleagues, and service to the program, the division, and the college. This year's recipient is simply outstanding in all these three areas. Colleagues describe this year's recipient as teaching with passion and zeal, and always seeking to live the mission of the college. She has served on countless committees and task forces, and students comment on the fact that the information she shares about her life and her work are instructive and helpful as they prepare for their chosen profession. In addition to her work with students in her program, she has also worked extensively with international students and has served as a host family for 5 different international students. She is well known in the community, particularly in the public schools. Please join me in recognizing Melissa Arnold as United Methodist.
The Begley Scholars Program was founded in 1997 to honor John B. Begley, who served as Lindsey Wilson's 6th president from 1977 to 1997. The award carries a full tuition, fees, room and board scholarship valued at over $33,000 a year. This year, 41 currently enrolled students competed for this honor. A 5-person committee reviewed the student essays, knowing only the student ID numbers of the participants. This year's recipient has earned a 3.90 GPA. She's a Governor Scholar with a 30 ACT, a psychophysiology major, a member of our marching band, and a Bonner Scholar, Would you please join me in welcoming our newest Begley Scholar from Elizabethtown, Kentucky, Kristen Holler. The President's Award is given to the graduate who, in the judgment of the President, has made the greatest contribution to the life of the college through Christian leadership, scholastic achievement, and devotion to Lindsey Wilson College. This year's recipient will graduate magna cum laude with a degree in middle grades education. He was a class president, a class vice president, a captain on the football team, a recipient of the L3 Leadership Award, and an academic All-American who started a math fun night at Adair County Middle School. Please join me in recognizing this year's recipient of the President's Award, the co-founder of the Kick Squad, Caleb Keaton.
We want to thank all of you for participating today. Would you please rise for the benediction and then remain standing for the recessional? Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for the joy of accomplishment and the beauty of lives well lived in service and in studies. Inspire us by these achievements so that we may serve you as we go with gladness in our hearts. This we pray in your name. Amen.